Hey everybody, my merch store is finally open, so you can head on over to it in the link in the description and grab some shit like this Daisy Monologue full print shirt, or this squeeze sweater and shirt. There's even a fucking backpack and a goddamn lunchbox. And for the next 2 weeks, you can even use the promo code 10off_magic for 10% off up until February 20th.
So get your fucking shit.
No. Bad. Sit. 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 No. Sit. Bad. Sit. Sit. No. Sit. Sit down. Sit. No, you fucking piece of shit. Oh, good boy. Good boy. Who's a good boy? Yes, who's a good boy?
Oh, shit.
Welcome to League of Legends Actual Champion Spotlight featuring Warwick, the uncaged Wrath of Zaun. Okay, just as a disclaimer, I won't be playing Thriller to this dance at any point during this video, right? It's just too easy, okay? We just can't do it. It's not something that's gonna happen, okay? If that's the reason why you wanted to watch this video, just for that stupid ass reason, okay, just turn around now because it's not gonna happen. Say Nick. Reworks on reworks on reworks. I'll probably get another fucking rework. But you know what? I'm actually really happy that Riot decided to change this guy around, because next to Dr. Mundo, Warwick was as basic as he could fucking get. I mean, like, we're talking Tanamangu basic.
He kind of like locks his arm around me, like around my neck.
Speak.
Heil Hitler.
Good boy. It took everything that you love about the old Warwick and just stuffed him with some updates. That's called bestiality. You still got a suppression. Your AP scaling is still there, so Darkmane can make another AP Warwick video. And you can still smell people from far away.
I can smell you.
Oh, give grandma a kiss, sonny boy. Even though this guy feels so goddamn clunky, he is just so much fun to play. You've got a speed boost that when it activates, you feel like someone rammed a rocket in your ass and lit it on fire. A lunge that follows people through anything, which is basically like Kled, except 10 times fucking cooler. Plus, you can finally gank pre-6. And it actually works. Remember the days when you would stay inside the jungle and have your team belittle you because you wouldn't gank their lane? Now you can just walk into a lane, tell your enemy,
"What's up guys, it's me, Jeremy. Today we're taking a look at what Warwick's rework is gonna be like."
And just shit all over them. It's like Christmas for all the old Warwick players out there, you know? It's like God came down and gave all the old Warwick players a massive fucking penis. You know, it's like Aubrey Plaza said that she was gonna blow you for 10 hours straight. It's like this picture of me in New York. You see, everybody else is happy, but I'm playing Warwick, so I'm obviously a fucking degenerate. And Riot gave us everything we needed to feel like a werewolf, you know? A pounce, running fast as fuck, you know, you're tanky as shit, and a leap that's just so incredibly huge. But most of the time, you'll either miss or just be slightly off on your ult, which makes you feel like complete shit. Because you feel like it's gonna hit, but just the smallest pixel, the smallest fucking decimal off, and fuck! What the fuck? Are you kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? Are you kidding me?
Oh my god.
I ulted right here. Right there. There's no fucking way. Your passive is Eternal Hunger. Your basic attacks deal additional magic damage on hit, and when you're below 50% health, your attacks also heal him for the amount of damage you dealt, tripling when below 25%. You know, this sucks. This passive is just completely deceiving to the enemy team and makes him such a huge tank once he gets some items under his belt. A lot of times it'll look like you're about to die, but then you fucking auto attack them and you just start healing back all of your health. And since you'll be building a Spirit Visage and a fucking Titanic Hydra, not only will you be dealing a fuckload of damage with your auto attacks, you'll also be healing for a huge amount of them just because of your damn passive. But not only do you get health from just your basic attacks, you also get it from your Q, Jaws of the Beast, since you heal 30 to 70% of the damage you deal with it, and it also deals max health damage scaling with 120% of your AD. Hey, and guess what? Still has an AP ratio. Woohoo! Riot is definitely making sure that off-meta builds are totally still here, you know? You better call Soul Wolf. The only meta you're breaking is that ADCs can do more than ADC and supports can carry an entire fucking game. Disrespect your surroundings! You won't make it out alive! You won't make it out! When I was making this montage, you know, I didn't even notice that there was a deer on Summoner's Rift. Guy's creepy as fuck.
Behold, this is my legacy. This rift, these people, my people, overseen by my knowledge. Only I am the rightful heir to this world and the king of all who stand before me.
The coolest thing about this Q is that if you hold it down, you pounce behind your enemy no matter what. You can attach to them through flashes, blinks, dashes, whatever it is, you'll lock onto them, and it's fucking amazing. For you. For them, it's like you drilled a hole into the back of their head and started skull fucking them. It feels so good when you see an enemy try to flash away from you, but you get your Q on them and you're still right next to them.
How's it going?
Hey, how's it going?
But it also feels so fucking clunky. Like, this mechanic is so weird because when you're chasing down someone, you can't hold down your Q while running towards them, because once you get into the range of your Q, it just won't work half the fucking time, and it's so goddamn aggravating. And now, thanks to Riot's practice tool, we can see how his Q works when chasing down an enemy, or we could just cover the map with iron bushes. Either way, this is just a way to prolong the video to go past the 10-minute mark. When using your Q and holding it down on an enemy, you'll attach onto them, right? But if you hold down your Q and then make a slight turn in order to dodge a skill shot, you'll only walk up to your enemy and your Q won't even activate. What you have to do if you move your cursor away from your target is that you have to then press Q 2 more times before being able to attach yourself. You can press it only once, but if you miss your target with your cursor, you'll only latch to your target and you won't follow them if they flash. Sometimes it works, and you know, and sometimes it doesn't. Either way, it's fucking confusing as shit. Right, we have a practice tool. You have a practice tool. How did you not see that this is gonna be fucking stupid?
One moment. You have reached the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline.
You know, it's a real pain in the ass to get used to, but once you figure it out, there's absolutely no way anyone is gonna get away from you. This is CNN breaking news. We have never before seen footage of Warwick on the scene with our field reporter, Jerry Jones. Which leads us to your W Blood Hunt. Hey, you guys want to know what it's like to play against a Warwick? Just play this sound throughout your entire fucking game.
He kind of like locks his arm around me, like around my neck.
The more points you put into your W, the more attack speed you'll gain against enemies that are below 50% health, which is the boring part. Now, the cool shit is that it also tracks all enemies globally if they're below 50%, giving him a massive amount of movement speed when you move toward them, and even better when they're below 20% health, your movement speed and attack speed is fucking tripled. At max rank, that's a 165% bonus fucking movement speed. How the fuck are you supposed to run away from that shit? Not only that, but even if you go invisible, as long as he's moving in your general direction, he'll still get a massive amount of movement speed in order to be able to find you. It's ridiculous, but it's also the best thing about his entire kit. It's just so much fun running across the entire map, chasing down an enemy champion on low health, and just tower diving them because you give absolutely no fucks and just want the guy fucking dead.
My only weakness. Slowing me down when I'm trying to run really fast.
But if they are able to get away, you lose all your movement speed, and that's when it starts to suck because Warwick's base movement speed just feels like complete ass. It's like you just did speed and got a taste of an extreme high only to come back down immediately and everything just feels extremely slow.
I am so reckless and destructive right now, and all I want is for you to force me to fuck you and dominate me.
Hey yo, I'm coming in! Oh fuck. Triple kill! Here comes Quad! That's the Quad! Where's she at?
There's Jink, there's your Penta, dude, over there.
I smell her! I'm coming for her! I'm coming! Here I come! Get over
it! I think I take it. Hey!
Over here!
That's for the montage.
Getting slowed so fucking much!
Yeah.
Oh, come on, dude.
Yeah, I bet.
Are you kidding me? Why am I not tanky enough, dude?
Look at that damage, dude. They killed me in like 5 hits.
Another shitty part is when you're jungling, your W passive will probably go off and you'll get a nice amount of movement speed, but then you have to check every single fucking lane to see who the hell is low, and most of the time it'll probably be in a lane that's completely opposite from where you're at. But if you do happen to get in the right spot at the right time, you know, it's time to just fucking hit that Nos, you know, ring that Nos, you know, you gotta go fast, yeah, gotta go fast, yeah, you gotta go fucking fast. Son of a bitch! You can also activate it and mark the champion closest to you and gain movement speed towards them that you would normally gain if they were at 50% health for 8 seconds, which is a great way to keep track of your enemy jungler or use for a gank on someone that isn't at 50% health. And even though its cooldown is super high when you activate it, the cooldown goes down twice as fast as long as you're not bloodhunting anyone. Primal Howl is your E. When activated, you reduce damage dealt to you for 2.5 seconds by 35 to 55%, which is why this guy works so well as a tank. Not only are you stacking health, movement speed, and resistances, you'll also have built-in damage reduction that when reactivated or after 2.5 seconds, you then fear everything around you for 1 second. So just like Hecarim, you've got an AoE fear, but unlike Hecarim, your fear is up every 15 to 11 seconds. Okay, let me reiterate that. An AoE fear and damage reduction every 15 to 11 seconds. Most of the time, you'll probably have about 30 to 40% CDR, which makes it almost every 7 fucking seconds.
But you know what? Reduced damage don't mean shit if they're building lethality. It probably will still deal like a goddamn fucking crit.
So basically, you want to press E, run into a squishy target, hold down Q, and fear everything around them. You can also use that as a good way to peel for your backline since you can cast the fear pretty much instantly once you activate your Primal Howl. And since fears now make people run away from the person that's feared, rest in peace, Fiddlesticks, you're able to push their backline into your team. But you know what? Let's take it just one step further. How can we make this game even less fun for an ADC? Oh, you know what? Let's give him an ult where he can leap to the fucking moon. Infinite Duress is your ult, and this shit is a goddamn masterpiece. Even though the hitbox on it is fucking weird as shit, and the indicator of how far you can jump is so hard to see that I didn't even know it existed for the first couple of games I played with him, it is probably one of the coolest ults in this entire fucking game.
Stop fighting me! Just let this happen.
Get off of me!
Stop being such a tease, you sweet little...
Using Warwick's ult now feels just as cool as using Jhin's ult. You leap in a straight line and suppress the first enemy champion that you hit for 1.5 seconds, dealing magic damage per hit, scaling with 55% of your AD, and also healing himself for the damage he deals to his target during the channel. It seems like his old ult, but just turn into a skill shot until you realize that its range increases with your movement speed, meaning the faster you go, the farther you can fucking jump since its range is 250% of your current movement speed. But it just feels so clunky. Sometimes you feel like that you'll hit them, but then you'll just be the slightest decimal off and you'll just completely miss and just stand there like an idiot. You can also activate your E right before you ult, so then you immediately proc the AoE fear, which sounds nice in theory, but you lose a majority of your tankiness because you lose your damage reduction. And since your ult relies on your movement speed and your base speed is fucking 335, the range on your ult without Bloodhunt's movement speed is so goddamn small, which sucks because it's the largest gap closer you have in order to initiate team fights. But when you see somebody low and you're just running at the speed of sound down a lane and you just fly across the entire fucking map, it is just so much fucking fun. Plus you get a heal off of it, you suppress them. His clear is pretty nice since his E reduces the damage from jungle camps and he gets a shit ton of sustain off of his Q, which means he can pretty much solo all of his camps and still have a pretty high health pool. The only shitty part about him is that he relies a lot on his movement speed from his W passive. And if your team is getting dumpstered, there's probably never gonna be a time when the enemy team is below half health so then you can actually utilize him and his movement speed the way that he needs to be used. Because when someone is at 20% health, holy shit, you thought Rengar ult was scary? Imagine seeing this guy without even a fucking warning sign come in and just hold you down doing whatever he wants to you for 1.5 seconds, which as we all know is a long ass time in anime time.
The world, tomare Tokyo!
What?
What the fuck?
Squeeze.